the abundance of information on the web that is not just textual, but also available in other media, changes the nature of computational linguistic research in a number of ways. We have to start branching out beyond our comfort zone, which is language, language modeling. Now, with the availability of data in video format, in hundreds of thousands of hours, assets that number into the millions, we need to look at how to integrate the different media data types. And that involves knowing not only how to use tools from the vision community, for example, and other data sources and data types that have been defined within the vision community, but we need to actually know how to extract textual information from video. We need to know how to identify sounds that are language and non-language sounds in the hope of integrating them into our language models that we've come to develop so successfully over the last 30 years. So the challenge is both, how do we actually adapt to this incredible amount of data that is non-language data? It's visual data, but it has language in it to a large extent. And how do we actually improve our linguistic models by virtue of creating aligned corpora for multimodal embeddings, co-training, and other sophisticated multimodal platforms that will improve our, not only our models, but also our understanding of what it means to communicate. Computers are collaborators with humans in the ability to accomplish and achieve tasks. So we need to not just use computers as giving us the results of search or some kind of information exploration, but in fact, to be able to engage with computers in a way that we would engage with someone that we're trying to accomplish a joint task. So what that involves is to be able to model the computer as though they're actually an intelligent, engaged partner in our research questions. And that means that we need to have richer, embodied agent models for our computers and what they know. The Clarin infrastructure should not be limited to Europe. It is essentially engaged with the dissemination, development, and cooperation and integration of tools and data that should cross countries and languages. So I believe that the United States can benefit greatly from involvement and participation in Clarin. We've been trying to do our own bit of Clarin-like infrastructural work in the language application grid, the LAPS grid, that is Brandeis and Vassar College and Carnegie Mellon and University of Pennsylvania Linguistics Data Consortium. And we are now currently involving other partners to create a platform for workflow and pipeline development that uses language tools. What Clarin offers is already a very nice success story for the integration of tools and data, as well as the development of standards that allow for the data to be interoperable on a syntactic level at least, and perhaps even semantically interoperable, the CMDI, for example, as well as exploratory environments such as the VLO. So I believe the United States can benefit from joining and participating in Clarin, but also from our own point of view, the LAPS grid is something that we've already integrated with much of Clarin, for example, the Weblicht platform in ClarinD, as well as Linda in Prague. And that's only a beginning of how we can try to bridge the tools that we have available from the United States and that we're trying to keep open and openly available with Clarin resources and Clarin data. But I believe even a more integrated participation of US partners to Clarin would actually be very much in US interest because of just the number of available resources and tools that you have. I think what the participants in Clarin should never forget is just how unique and how special Clarin is as an organization. Coming from the United States, where funding for language infrastructure is challenging and difficult to secure at best. It is typically something that comes from government agencies other than the National Science Foundation. And by that I mean, for example, DARPA. And while these funding agencies are incredibly generous and very, very useful for creating large platforms for directed programs, such as the one that I am enthusiastically involved in right now, the Communicating with Computers, which brings up the simulation work, I think you should never lose sight of the specialness that Clarin has as an opportunity to create general infrastructural programs and methodologies that are really independently motivated and without any type of applications specific to, for example, commerce, e-commerce, or the military. So I think this is a really special type of program that you should never lose sight of the specialness of this funding source.